It's terrifying how your life can change in the blink of an eye. Who knew that a distress signal could unveil such dark and forgotten history? It was supposed to be another quick harvest. Get in, reap what you can, get out. 10 minutes, tops. It turned out to be much more complicated than that. My name is Nova Dune, and this is my journey into Krystopia. A lot of the objects I found were ancient to me, but I could feel that some of them were brimming with energy. I had yet to find what they were used for.
Thank you.
Curiousness got the best of me when I carefully put my lips against the mouthpiece of the old flute-like instrument and gently blew. As I fell backwards, ears bleeding, I knew that I would never again underestimate the dangers of this planet. It was obvious that life once flourished here. Whatever civilization that built this place didn't joke around with their culture. Even though I enjoyed exploring the lost temples and ruins, I couldn't help myself from feeling uneasy. Where had all the people gone? It was as if everyone suddenly left, for no reason at all. There were no signs of struggle either. As the words left my mind, I froze when I looked closer at my surroundings. I was definitely not the first visitor. Visiting new planets is always exciting. You think you've seen it all. Reality hits you with a slap in the face when you come upon a plant that makes fart noises when you touch it.
Thinking
drinking some unknown beverage from an alien planet would be a whole new level of stupid. What if I'm allergic? Or maybe it's poisonous? Leaving the mysterious content forever unknown and never knowing the taste of it is the way to go. Did I drink it? Yes, I took a small sip. I remember the handheld translator I found in a weird storage room. The visitors didn't come here on a whim. They were extremely prepared and knew how they would approach the natives. Crystalline plant in my hand, I felt every strand of hair rise on my body. The amount of energy was incredible. I figured that taking one, or some, wouldn't hurt. Obviously for research purposes. Thank you. It was right under their feet. Resources enough to power a sun if they wanted to. All they lacked was the knowledge of how to do it. A knowledge that wasn't too far away. The visitors knew exactly what they had found. A crystalline substance that would help them survive and prosper for millions of years. Their civilization was saved. And together with the native population, they started building the ultimate paradise. But something must have stopped them. Was there a conflict? Maybe an accident? Or a virus? No, it didn't make sense. As my journey continued, I soon realized that I had missed one huge piece of the puzzle. It was just like any shoe. But if you looked closer, you'd find all kinds of features. Temperature sensors, air conditioning, gravitational pull, radio integration. It's crazy how I can make this all up since it was actually just a normal shoe. Thank you. Their field research was all over the place. It's like they couldn't decide on what they wanted to do. Mining? Biology? Breeding? Politics? Anyway, I found a lonely egg laying around, and I think I can hear something from the inside. Who wouldn't want to go on an adventure around the galaxy with an adorable space pet? The nifty-looking tool I found laying around the mining site. I started fiddling with it and figured that pressing the big red button would satisfy my interest. Now, not only do I need a new eyebrow, but I'll also never again need to use a shovel for digging. Thank you. Isn't it a heartwarming thought? Two alien races coming together to enjoy a simple board game. I think a lot of species in this galaxy could learn from this. It was absolutely certain that it was no ordinary building I had found. They were doing something there. Maybe it was connected to the disappearance? I gathered courage and, with a deep breath, stepped inside the building. After a few steps, I almost choked from the thin air. But there was something more. A surge of energy overwhelmed me. My surroundings started to vibrate. And I was afraid that coming here was a huge mistake. I ran, but it was too late. The large metal entrance closed before my eyes as I was trying to escape. Darkness fell before me, and I started to feel dizzy from the lack of air. Had I already met the final chapter of my journey? A buzz came from somewhere above, and I could feel my consciousness coming back to me. Air was pouring into the building, and a complex setup of lights washed away the darkness. I could barely stand upright as my shaking legs were betraying me, not out of fear, but out of excitement that their secrets would soon belong to me. Doll really gave me the creeps. When I looked at it, I couldn't stop thinking of containment and isolation. An uncomfortable chill creeping up my spine when I found the old dusty blueprints. The facility, its purpose, the disappearance. I realized I had overlooked something very important. It all seemed so perfect. Two civilizations coming together to create a cosmic paradise. But at what price? The universal fuel that makes the world go round. It didn't even surprise me to find it on the most desolated planet in the galaxy. What a time to be alive! When I looked up and down at the dotted map, I could only imagine one thing. Whatever they were doing here was being done at several identical facilities. What could have been so important? overlooked it for so long that there was no doubt. The natives, the real natives, whatever went down on this planet was probably more gruesome than I had expected. It was almost as if the visitors were trying to remove them from history.